Thunderdome Boxing Talk, Anthony here. Alright, sorry guys, I took them few days off for the holidays. You know, I've just been extremely busy. I didn't plan on taking them days off, it just kind of happened that way. Like I said, I was just too damn busy, but today I'm officially back. And this was a story I wanted to cover on the day it broke, on December 26th. But thankfully, Don Juan Banks over at Enter the Arena, shout out to you, Don, and him and Kenny Lopez discussed this issue, and also shout out to Big Kenny, and they Don Juan put together a video, you know, about this, so, you know, props to him, you know, he was on this first, so, you know, in no way, shape, or form, I trying to step on his toes or anything like that. I just feel it's something I also need to address. You know, and that's the interview that Alan Fox did with Dan Raphael over from ESPN. You know, Alan Fox, I believe he works for Boxing News 24, and that's the site that the interview is up on. You know, it's you know, he started off by saying the negotiations between Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao for a fight on May 2nd aren't going too well, according to Dan Raphael of ESPN.com, okay? Raphael is saying that Pacquiao's side is doing all the work in trying to make the fight happen, you know? And they're not having much luck, he says, okay? His exact words right there. If the fight doesn't get made for 2015, it would be a huge pity for the fans because this is clearly the biggest fight in the sport. There's really nothing out there that can compare to a fight this big. And it's true. I mean, when you get a fight of this magnitude, more people watch these type of fights than, like, the Super Bowl. You know, even though boxing is like a niche sport and, you know, it has, you know, it's casual fans and it's diehard fans, when there's a fight to be had of this magnitude, it trumps every other sporting event out there, you know? I mean, everyone wants to see a big fight, a mega fight, and this is one of them, you know? And it looks like, you know, that this little January 1st shit is not going to be coming true. And it looks as though Floyd Mayweather is stalling this fucking fight from happening. You know, this is Dan's words, you know, this is Dan in quotes, okay? Quote, as far as I know, it's been one-way traffic on Manny's side trying to make it, meaning the fight, okay? As I understand it, Les Moonves is in contact with the Mayweather camp and not getting anywhere, okay? End quote. Okay, not getting anywhere. Wasn't Floyd the one that went on fucking Showtime and said, I want this fucking fight, you know? And Manny was the one on HBO and everywhere else saying, I want this fight. Well, how come Manny's pushing for this fight and Floyd's not doing dick? You know, he even got the fucking, you know, the CEO, CBS, Les Moonves, coming down there to bust his balls about, take this fucking fight so we can make some money, you know, so we're not, you know, gonna just stay in the fucking red, for the rest of your contract. You know, we were trying to recoup some money here too, Floyd, you know, but Floyd don't give a fuck about CBS, he don't give a fuck about Moonves, he sure as shit don't give a fuck about the fans. He always says, like, screw the fans, you know, when I'm gone, you know, I retire, they're just gonna move on to the next guy. Well, doesn't he realize he wouldn't have shit? He wouldn't have them fucking Bentleys and them Rolls Royces and that fucking Vegas mansion if it wasn't for you guys, you know, the fans out there that actually buy his fights, okay? So he owes everything to the fans. It's not like... How's he going to ever say, screw the fans? You know, they don't care about me. They don't care about you. They're giving you $70 a whop every fight. Boom. You know, knocking it right out. They're giving you fucking... All the millions you're collecting is coming out of their collective pockets, you know? But it's screw the fans, you know? It's crazy. It's fucking crazy. I mean, Manny's out here trying to please the fans, give the fans what they want. every boxing fan wants to see this fight. And if you don't want to see the fight, it's because you're afraid your guy's going to lose. And that goes for both sides. You know, some Manny fans don't want to see the fight because they don't want to see Floyd beat him. And then some Floyd fans don't want to see the fight because they don't want to see Manny beat him. Well, guess what? I want to see the fucking fight. Okay, like 99% of us do. All right, and there's about 3 million of us that are willing to pay $100 to watch this motherfucking fight. You know? I mean, God, man, Floyd, just sit down with them, you know? Like, my God, man. I thought Les Moonves was going to be able, you know, I think even Les, he knew that Floyd, he didn't have complete control over the ability to make Floyd take the fight, you know, but he does have the power to pull the contract and end it in litigation and pull all of Heyman's dates, you know, and he can go on NBC, you know, which is going to be bought time, so he can put on all the shit fights he wants down there, and it's not going to matter at all because, I mean, he's going to buy chunks of time to put the fights on, you know. But, you know, I thought Moonves, I thought with the threat of we're going to pull all your dates, you know, and, you know, you settle off Floyd's contract and litigation would be enough. I mean, he already said he don't want to fight Khan, you know. And you can take that either way. You can say, yeah, Khan could win rounds on him and he's scared to take that fight. Or, you know, he just really, like, there's no reason he wouldn't fight Khan, right? If he thought he could beat him, because that's the type of, if he thinks he can easily beat you, he takes that fight in a heartbeat. He wanted Khan the whole way up until this Khan puts on this great performance against Devin. Then all of a sudden it's Khan ain't shit. Khan hasn't proved himself. But he was just saying that Khan was, like, likely his next opponent. So I don't get that, right? The only way, they wanted Khan to put on a good performance. That way they could, make that fight, right? But Khan put on, like, too good of a performance. And now they don't even want the Khan fight, right? And they don't want to fight Manny. So who the fuck can he fight? Like, who out there that you would buy? Right, because the only match right now that people want to see, because we want to see him, if he has two fights left, we want to see him in two competitive fights, you know, make it the first one Manny Pacquiao, you know, if you know, the first one is like a shutout and someone just gets destroyed, then fuck the rematch, you know, but if it's close, have the rematch, we'd be happy with them for the two fights, you know, and Floyd would just get credit, you know, you'd have to give him credit just for stepping up and taking the fight, you know, and it doesn't even matter that both fighters are diminished because, like, we still need answers to this debate, you know. People have been arguing for 5 years over who will beat who and who will beat who, and it's gotten so serious, like, racist remarks and, I mean, just name-calling and just ignorant-ass childish shit, you know. When it can all, these guys can just settle it in May and boom, the fight's fucking on. And then we get the answers, you know? And then one side is going to be like, I told you so, right? You know, and I want the fight. I want to see, you know, who's gonna win. I mean, what the fuck else do I watch boxing for? I want to see the best fight the best, you know? But this whole thing with this quote, you know, as far as I know, it's been one-way traffic on Manny's side trying to make it. As I understand it, Les Moonves is in contact with the Mayweather camp and not getting anywhere. Like, wow, like, yo, all right, Dan might not know shit about, like, the technical aspects of boxing, okay, but anything that he prints is, like, he's not a bullshit journalist, all right, if he fucking says it or prints it, it's, like, it's fact. I mean, the dude don't come on, he comes correct constantly. You know, he's not someone, like, you'll never hear him talk, like, technical shit about a fight, but when he gives you, like, numbers and, like salaries or negotiation shits like that, he's on point, right? That's what he specializes in, you know? I mean, so it's telling, this isn't, like, I don't know, I guess it's not, it shouldn't have been unexpected. It should have been expected with, you know, what we have gotten over the last 5 years. But I like, hey, you guys know, I fully believe this fight was popping off, and now I am in serious fucking doubt that it'll ever happen. Like, there's just too much going on right now, man. Floyd obviously doesn't want the fight, and if Les Moonves is getting nowhere, then, I mean, that was our hope. Our hope was that Les Moonves could, like, kind of talk him into it, force him into it, and then we could get the fight. But if Les ain't even getting nowhere, it's bullshit. And you know, you can blame Floyd, but also blame fucking Heyman, man. This is a big deal about Heyman, right? Heyman, like, shout out to Scoop also for, he did a great article on why Manny and Floyd can't happen, because Floyd can't take the chance of losing, you know, because he's Heyman's crown jewel, you know. And if, you know, Floyd goes down the toilet, Heyman loses a lot of power within the boxing world, with the networks, and, you know, he needs that power, you know, he needs that power, to really, you know, I mean, otherwise he'll just become another, you know, small-time promoter. And they've also, even the smaller guys, you know, they've all put on great fights, you know, but whenever you don't have a superstar in your stable, it's a little hard to wield power in the boxing world, okay? And Floyd is Heyman's superstar, and he needs him, and he needs him undefeated, you know, and I'm sure Heyman, like, come on, man, he's Floyd Money Mayweather. You're getting offered over 100 mil, guaranteed, probably looking at, like, 160 million, you know, after all is said and done, you know, and then he has to, you know, have to pay his taxes and promoter and all that out of that, but still, that's more than he's ever made. You know, that's like four times more than he's ever made, you know, three times, it's almost four, you know. And to fight a guy who he calls an amateurish midget, you know what I mean, but he won't take the fight, what does that tell you, you know? He's really worried about Bob making money. He hates Oscar. He don't care if Oscar's making money off of him. He hates Oscar. And he'll go cash them checks that Oscar signs for him, you know, and gives him, right? Oscar pays Floyd, okay? But, you know, he don't have a problem with Oscar taking his cut, but all of a sudden he got this problem with fucking Aram, and then people will be like, well, Aram still owes him money. Well, guess what? If he said, hey, give me that $3-4 million you owe me from them two fights with Zab and Gaddy, pay me that right now, guess what? That'll get paid immediately, and that beef can be squashed, you know, and then they can go on to the real business, the Manny Pacquiao Floyd Mayweather fight. But Heyman and Floyd don't want it. They don't want it, you know. I knew they didn't want it, but I thought they would be forced into taking it, you know. I mean, hopefully Les can get somewhere. I don't know, but I see it as Floyd stalling his fight out, knowing that if, you know, if we don't hear something in January, then Pacquiao and Aram have to go somewhere else. What do you want them to do, sit around till March, you know, and just, like, see who and wait for Floyd to announce a fight first? Like, no, they're not going to do that. You know, if they know if he's going to take it or not. Whenever Moonves comes back to him and says, look, I can't get him to take it, we've tried everything, we hit a dead end, you know, they're gonna say fuck it, and they're gonna go off somewhere else. That's what Floyd's waiting for. Soon as Manny signs another fight, he's gonna sign a fight, and then come out and be like, I wanted Manny Pacquiao, I tried getting that fight made, but you see they went and signed with this fight over here. You know, it's like, no, that ain't what happened. They fucking tried and tried and tried, and you wouldn't even talk to them, okay? Like, you... So whenever he signs his next fight, whether it's against Khan or Danny Garcia or some shit, you know, like, expect him to say that. You know he's going to say that. And all his little fans are going to run with it, you know, saying, well, hey, Floyd tried making it. Well, look, here's the fucking proof, okay? As of January, or as of December 26th, Floyd would not even fucking talk negotiations with these guys, you know? Les Moonves, own words, not getting anywhere, okay? You know, Dan Raphael talked to him. Moonves told Raphael, I'm not getting anywhere. You know, meaning, Why is he going to... He's not going to keep wasting his time on this. The dude runs a fucking, you know, a Fortune 500 company, you know. He don't got time to sit there and go cater to fucking Floyd Mayweather and, you know, beg him to take a fight for his career-high payday. You know, that money Mayweather shit needs to go. Because he ain't Floyd Money May. You know, it should be like Floyd Zero Mayweather. Because that's what he's all about, that zero. It is not the money, it's the zero, okay? If he was all about that money, he would be taking this fight, right? But it's more, like, he might be all about the money, but he's more about that zero, you know? He knows that zero, if it gets taken away, everything he built is gone. Is gone, you know? But then him also not taking the fucking Manny fight puts an asterisk on his whole career, and then it makes people look deeper into his career, you know, like the exposed vid I did. You can look deep into his career and be like, wait a second, there's a pattern here, you know. He didn't just do this with Manny, you know. He's been doing this shit his whole career. So, like, I mean, you know, I'm so pissed, you know. I'm pissed. There's no way, there's no reason he shouldn't take this fight. I don't give a fuck if he thinks he's gonna get beat. You still take the fight. You know why? Because you have a chance at winning, okay? You have a chance. Like, I don't care if in his mind he just thinks, look, I don't want that fight. I don't like that style matchup. I don't want that fight. Well, guess what? Sign the damn contract and then start believing, you know, twist them beliefs and start saying, no, I can beat this guy. I'm going to train my ass off. I'll make a great game plan. I'll adjust in the fight, and I'll win, you know, and I'll prove everyone wrong. You know, he needs to start thinking like that and take the damn fight. When you have, like, a possible, no matter what, they can do two fights. Even if the first one is a blowout, they can still do two fights because everyone's going to want to see a rematch, right? No matter what. It don't matter if one of the dudes gets knocked out in the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth round and dominated every round. We still want to see a rematch because we want to know, like, well, what did he learn in that fight? Can he improve? Let's see this again, right? So he's looking at, like, $300 million for two fights. Or he can go make $60 million for his next two fights. Does that make any sense? No, it doesn't. It doesn't at all. He can make, that's like a guaranteed $300 million for two fights, okay? It's a guaranteed at least $250 million, you know? Or he's going to go take $60 for two fights, you know, even $80 for two fights. Say he gets $40, which, I mean, I think he's supposed to get like $32, and then, you know, cut of the pay-per-view, so say like $40 million, alright? Say $80 million. Does that still even make sense over $250 million? You know what I mean? That's three times the size. More than three times. You're going to get paid three times the amount for the same amount of fights. And you won't take it. Why? Why? Alright, the drug test issue, out of the way. So it has nothing to do with that. Plus, fucking Pacquiao's been doing VADA testing for forever now. For, you know, his last three fights anyway. So, and he's been clean on all of them. Floyd, on the other hand, uses USADA, but I'm not even going to get into that. If anyone should be saying, take the test, Manny should be telling Floyd, take the test. Alright? Testing, out of the way. Purse split. That's solved. I mean, come on. Floyd's, they already said he'll get the lion's share. You know, what's he want? 80-20? 75-25? Well, no, that's not happening. Because you can't make the amount of money with anyone else. You want to go try and do it with Cotto? And watch how much money you make. You'll make $40 million. But guess what? You put Pacquiao in that ring, you make $150 million. Okay, so, and that's him. That's not the fight. That's Floyd. So why is he even worrying what fucking Manny is getting? You take your $150 and you let Pacquiao take his $100. $50 million more? That's good. That's real good. You know, you're making, you know, 30% more. You know, 33.3333% more. I mean, come on. But no, that's not good enough for him. And would that be good enough for you? Ask yourself, would that be good enough for you? I think everyone would say yes to that. Yes, the hell yeah, I'm signing that contract instantly, right? Why won't he take the fight? Why won't he even entertain the negotiations? Because if he knows, if he starts to entertain the negotiations, he might get stuck in there. You know, he might, you know, accidentally, you know, like, take the fight. You know, but he don't want the fight. You know, he's pricing himself out. He's stalling the fight. I can't even say he's pricing himself out because he's not even giving himself a real price. You know, he's just turning down every price. So, I mean, what, you know, it's crazy. It is straight crazy. There's no excuse that you can give for Floyd to not take this fight. I think everybody in the boxing world thinks he has to take this fight. And if he doesn't, it only says one thing. What else could it say? Why else would you turn down a two-fight deal for $250 to take two fights for, say, $80? Why else would you turn down that big money? Because you can't win. If you can win both, you obviously take the bigger money. Without a blink, you don't even got to think. You just take the bigger money, right? But there's a risk with this bigger money, okay? And the $80 million... No risk. A puncher's chance risk. That's what's over here. What's over here is an all-time great, all-time great, higher up than Floyd. So he knows he's fighting the real deal over here. And he can fight someone that gives him every advantage in the world and isn't even on the level skill-wise. You know? So he's going to go the safe route. But he said this guy over here, you know, Manny is an amateurish midget who's not on his level. Why not take the fight then? Why not make your fucking hundreds and hundreds of millions? Why not take your $250 million if you can just destroy this dude, right? But he still don't want to take it. I mean, that can only tell you one thing. He don't believe he can win, you know, or he doesn't like his chances. You know, he might think he has a chance to win, but we all know Floyd likes to have like an 80% chance of winning, and he wants his opponents to have a 20% chance of winning. Manny and Floyd right now, it's a 50-50. You know, you can go up and down on either side and point reasons why, but if anyone has an edge, it is Manny, okay? It's 100% Manny. I mean, we just saw what a B-level fighter Maidana did to Floyd. You know, 24 rounds, and Floyd was never able to do anything. You know, he had to run and hold. I mean, come on, man. He ain't even going to be able to hold Manny. Because you ever see him, he reaches in, he goes like this, and then grabs in. That fucking woof, that left is coming right down the pipe. He tries to do that. Manny will take a step back. Floyd's arms will be flailing. He'll go to cover up. Blam, he's going to get smashed. So that grab and shit, no. Have you ever seen anyone hold Manny? No, trust me, people have tried, but you can't tie him up because he's fucking everywhere, punching you constantly, okay? So Floyd ain't going to be able to hold this guy. He ain't going to be able to pot shot him and hold him and win on points like he did in the second fight for Maidana, okay? He knows he got a tough fight over there. And in his mind, apparently, the risk isn't worth the reward. You know, he would rather take on, like he said, he'd rather take on two duds. That's his own words. I can take on two duds, okay? Or he can take on Manny Pacquiao twice. No, he don't like them odds. He don't like the Manny Pacquiao odds at all, okay? Not at all. Even if, like, he's looking at it like, well, I got a 60-40 chance of beating Manny, right? Well, he don't like Manny having a 40% chance of beating him. Okay, that's more than he's ever given up in the ring, you know? So he's going to just be like, no, can't do it. If he don't take the fight, there's only one reason why. Because he thought Manny, he thought he couldn't beat Manny, okay? And he thought Manny would beat him. It's the only reason. If you can come up with one reason why that isn't that reason, I need to know about it, okay? Because that's the only reason, and I'm brainstorming out of the pocket here, you know, trying to, you know, why wouldn't he take this fight? Like, why not? I don't know why. You know, I don't know why. The only reason I could think of is, you know, what else could it be? You know, I explained it clearly. You got 250 over here for two fights, or 80 over here. If you can beat both guys, why not take the 250 instead of the 80? You know, I mean, that says it all. It says it all. You know, then they go on. You know, it's unclear what Mayweather would want for him to make the fight happen with the 36-year-old Pacquiao. 38-year-old Floyd Mayweather. If Moonves from CBS isn't getting anywhere with Mayweather, then it's possible that Mayweather's side is asking for something that Pacquiao's team isn't willing to give them. Probably money. He probably wants 80% of the split or something like that. You know, the only thing that you can think of is that a problem, perhaps Mayweather's asking for too much money. You know, a 60-40 purse split is likely. I think that's completely fair. You know, or possibly 70-30 in favor of Mayweather would be fair in the eyes of some boxing fans, because Mayweather is unbeaten and he's clearly the A-side in the negotiations. But with a fight this big, is there really even an A-side or a B-side? Because this is the biggest fight in history, okay? Like Lennox Lewis, Mike Tyson, when they put on that fight, there was no real A-side, B-side. They just said split it. You know, split it. You know, whatever. You know, split it down the middle, you know? Because we're going to both make career-high paydays, be the biggest fight in history, and Lewis needed Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson needed Lennox Lewis's name. Okay, they could have fought anyone else, but the money would have never been there. But you put them two names together, all of a sudden, it's like the fucking price is astronomical. You know, same with Floyd. He can go fight someone for $30 million. Pac can go fight someone for $25 million. But guess what? You put them guys together, now all of a sudden it's like a $300 million fight. You know? And that's why, like, hey, if this was Lennox and Tyson, they went 50-50. You know, why can't Floyd, like, concede to anything? They're not even, Pacquiao's camp ain't even asking for 50-50. You know, they're saying, like, 60-40. You know, we'll give you 20% more. That's a lot! Like, we're talking a $300 million fight, 20%? A lot. Okay? That's like $60 million, all right? And plus, they're going to give them, you know, come on. It's more than enough. 20% is more than enough. You know, that's 70-30. That's a fucking other slap in the face offer. That's worse than when he was saying $40 million with no pay-per-view. You know, that's worse because then it's like, wow, I'm really going to go do the biggest fight in history and get fucking, like, the same thing I always get. Really? I'm gonna get a tad more while this guy makes 6 times more than his biggest payday? I'm really gonna do that? Or 5 times more? Like, no. You know, no sane businessman would ever do that. Okay? You know, and he goes on, some fans feel that Mayweather should automatically agree to give Pacquiao a healthy purse split. Because Mayweather couldn't make this kind of money facing anyone else in boxing. There you go. That's the argument I've just been making. That's, you know, I mean, come on, man. That's the only way I can see it. If you can't make this money with anyone else, why do you care what he's getting? As long as you're getting 3-4 times your most ever, you should be happy. Why you gotta fucking watch Manny's pockets? Why you gotta be worrying about what this dude's bringing in? Just worry about what you're getting, you know? But, you know, that's just an excuse. It is. It's just an excuse. It's so he doesn't have to take the fight, you know? You know, that's all it is, man. It's pathetic. Like, I don't know, man. Let me know how you guys feel about this. I'll put a link to this article, you know, in the description box. I'm sure a lot of you have already read it, though, anyway. I just felt I needed to kind of talk about it. So Thunderdome Boxing Talk saying stay safe and peace till next time.